Interior Secretary Benjamin Abalos calls on local government units to reinforce measures against the spread of COVID-19. On Tuesday, the health department warned there was a possibility daily COVID-19 cases could reach 10,000 in Metro Manila by October. But on Friday, the DOH noted signs of improvement in COVID figures in the NCR, saying the number of new COVID-19 infections in the past 3 days is not far from the figures last week. Also on Friday, the DOH recorded 4,661 new COVID cases with 28 new deaths. The positivity rate from August 7 to 11 is at 18.4%. The country's positivity rate has also seen a very slight decrease. Trends in the national capital region, the rest of Luzon and the Visayas, are also showing improvements.
Actually,
for ABS-CBN data analytics head Edson Guido, there may be signs that a peak is being reached if only the trend will continue.
Kailangan at least a week of monitoring talaga na makita natin na talagang malinaw na may pagbaba sa mga numbers at hindi lang pagbaba na isang araw, dalawang araw, kailangan sustained. What we need to see is a clear and sustained downward trend talaga.
Based on previous experiences, a decline in infections in the capital region is usually followed by the improvements of data in other regions. But the DOH reminds both experts and the public to exercise caution in interpreting data.
Sa NCR po, 17.7, medyo bumaba because as we have said a while ago, nagpa-plateau ang mga kaso sa National Capital Region. But also, I said that we should be careful in interpreting this slowdown of the number of cases because it can still be affected by a lot of factors like the number of samples being submitted para matest.
The DOH continues to advise the public to maintain a high level of caution, especially since health authorities continue to detect more samples infected with more transmissible Omicron subvariants. The BA.5 sublineage has been detected in most of the samples sequenced. This is followed by the BA.4 and BA.2.12.1. The good news, most of them have already recovered. Meanwhile, more than 72 million Filipinos are now considered fully vaccinated. But booster uptake needs to be pushed further after only 16.8 million Filipinos are recorded to have had the extra jab. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.